Make learning interesting in a way that then amplifies what careers there are out there.
BusinessJournalDaily.com. 3 minutes with is brought to you by Farmers National Bank.
Well, you know, to me, the most amazing thing is we're seeing stronger and stronger business education partnerships forming around business advisory councils, right? In the past, we've always thought about business advisory councils as a place where a district might, you know, want the business community on board for their levy campaign or just make them aware of things. Now they're really partnering in providing activities and services to students and really helping increase the understanding of the jobs in the area, the careers that can be gained in the area, the kind of training and education that's needed to be successful in those careers. And we're seeing that all over the place, blossoming, and businesses and schools seeing the value of that, and students being the beneficiaries. You know, both in terms of what happens academically, but then in terms of work-based learning experiences, internships, opportunities after school, opportunities to visit businesses or do work-based learning opportunities that might involve a particular sector or what have you. So I think people understand that when students have those kind of experiences, it makes the learning a lot more relevant, and they see the connection between math and science and what they might be doing with an employer, and that really makes those connections and builds excitement. We have a chronic absence problem. You know, kids don't want to come to school, so they're not excited about what's going on. That excitement can be amplified when there's a strong business connection or work-based learning opportunities, and so we're constantly trying to emphasize the importance of that. You know, as a state, we don't like to force people into things, but I think the more people understand the value of that, they come to it on their own, and their business community helps them get there, and then the students are the ones who benefit. You know, manufacturing is an amazing industry with so many pieces and parts and so much that can be attractive to a person. And a lot of times people think, well, maybe that's not something I want to go into, or maybe I can't master the mathematics or some of the other parts of it. But at the end of the day, they see how it really is, you know, something exciting, something interesting, and it draws them to it. We're learning what works with kids. We're learning how technology maybe can be a much more significant part of the educational experience. So I think that, you know, has had an impact. Kids have missed the social interactions that come with school, and I think we see that happening, and our connections with the mental health community and other child caring organizations, you know, show that, and we're seeing a lot of schools making sure they pay attention to that as we continue to go forward. What we're seeing is more and more people, again, to that point of the relevancy and the engagement of the academic experience, they're saying, hey, STEM is really something that draws students in. How can we infuse those ideas into our, you know, high school experience, our middle school experience, and really strengthen what students are learning in a way that has relevancy and that builds their engagement? Well, I think people need to understand that those are amazing jobs. There's always going to be a demand for them. Those are high-paying jobs, and you can make a career out of those. And then what I also try to emphasize to students is that, you know, just getting a journeyman's, you know, card isn't the end of the line. You can get an associate's degree. You can go on to get a bachelor's degree in, you know, materials joining if you're a welder or what have you. So there's always learning and additional growth opportunities, never mind if you're an entrepreneur of starting your own business. So I think sometimes we sell those professions short because people don't really understand not only what they are, but ultimately what they can lead to and how you can make a career out of that. And we just need to do a better job. I think we are doing a better job. We see the unions and the employers coming together to sort of strengthen the message that we send to kids about those kind of professions. And I think we're starting to see more and more students interested and excited about those opportunities.
Thanks for watching the video. Be sure to like, subscribe, and hit that little bell for notifications. And also make sure to connect with us on Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn. For all of your business news, visit BusinessJournalDaily.com. For all of your arts and entertainment news, go to AfterHoursYoungstown.com.
BusinessJournalDaily.com. 3 minutes with is brought to you by Farmers National Bank.
I like a bank that's a pillar in my community.
I like a bank so cutting edge, they have a lab branch.
We are so alike.
Well, we do both bank at Farmers National Bank.
Farmers.
Stand strong.